All right, guys, we're back again. Another video on the scooter. Today I don't have a whole lot planned, but I figured something. I'm gonna do those horns I showed you guys in the last video. Of course, I already went ahead and did most of it because all I have is my phone, so it's hard for me to show like while I'm doing it. But I'll show you the bracket. It's a piece of random metal I had laying around that I've kept for some reason. But let me show you that now. So that's what we got going on. Bracket, if you can see it, uses the you can't see it, uses the same shock mount bracket. So that's what it looks like in the rear. Basically, you can see in there, just a, there you go, just a straight metal bracket. I had a leftover piece of this. I don't really know where I got it, but worked out good because I made a bracket to hold the three horns together, and then had long bolts in it so that I could slip them in here and put nuts on the back of this so I could move it back and forth. But yeah, that's what it's up. So I did figure out what we're gonna do with the exhaust tip. I'm not gonna tell you, but it's gonna be pretty cool. I'm gonna make it removable and have the springs kind of hold it on. Also, another thing I do need to do is, let's see, I think it's right here. Let's set that over there for now. Figure out how to make this radiator work, or did a different one. This is the factory Elite one. Something sitting right there. I don't know. It's kind of hard to find a good spot that looks nice. But until then, I don't know what I'm gonna do. All right, so I took a second, mounted the motor, the pump, and ran some hoses to the horns. Fortunately, I don't have any solder. I'm an idiot. When I go back to pick my battery from Advance, I will pick up some solder. That way I can wire it into the horn button and we'll be able to hear these things. But here's what it looks like so far, and then I'll put the plastics on. You can see that too, but.
It all looks pretty uniform. I took some time, that way like the part down by the horn that you actually see looks nice. It comes up here, I moved whatever this is. I think it's just a ballast or something. Moved that out of the way, drill the hole, simple mount. Angle it just a smidge. Basically, just gotta run one wire here, I believe, and there's one battery and positive on the back side. But let me get this piece of this panel thrown on, and we'll see it with it all together. Panel on. Here it is with the panel on. Looks sick, because you can see the hoses, but they're all evenly spaced, and they all kind of swoop up at the same. Overall, I think that came out really cool. I definitely want to paint that bracket black, though, so it doesn't stick out so much. But like I said, Tennessee right now, it's super cold. I can't paint anything, which is why we aren't doing any fiberglass either. Because it is going to have a fiberglass wing, and the cowl, I'm not sure about how to do, but fiberglass wing, headlight visor, all done out of fiberglass, so has to be pretty warm to do that. Let me know if you have any ideas for the radiator. I still kind of brain farting about where I want to put that. I'd rather not see it, but don't really have that option on this thing because we're running out of space. I don't know if you can see me, it's dark. I just got back from Advance Auto Parts, grabbing the battery, and I got some solder. I couldn't help myself, so I threw the battery back in the scooter, started it up. Wow, that'll be the next clip here. I didn't film it like this. I did film it, but we'll see. On the last clip, the exhaust sounds pretty decent. It's got a bunch of exhaust leaks because it's just tacked together. I plan on I didn't want to grind down a bunch of MIG welds. I want to see if someone can TIG weld it for me, so it looks nice. Won't have to do any finish work then. But today we're gonna hook up the horns, we're gonna make them work with the factory button. So I'll show you how to do that. It's pretty simple. Find the horn here. We're gonna turn the key on. I'm gonna pull one of these off. These have already been taped up, so it's gonna be pretty simple to do, but one of these is power, one of them is ground, and we're just gonna find out which one's power. Run a wire back to the pump, and should be as simple as that, and then you'll hear it. So. All right, after I messed that up a couple times, I don't know how, but finally got the pump to turn on and the horns to blow. It's not what I was expecting, but
given the style of the build, I'm okay with it. So I had to wire in a relay, which came with the thing. Right there, pretty simple standard relay. I did run out of run, so the header's starting to get some cool color. Wish it was welded, but whatever. Anyways, so I'll show you what it sounds like. It's pretty hilarious. Yeah. That's something. I'm not sure why there's four ports on this hub and this pump. And then on the instructions, it actually came with a Y connector for the middle horn. So I'm wondering if maybe that's why it kind of does the song, I guess you want to call it, instead of just a straight horn noise. But I'm gonna do some research on that. Maybe just get some more hose and just try it, and let's see how it sounds then. So in the last clip, I told you I was going to add that Y into the horns to the pump. I did that, put all the panels back on just because they don't need to be off. And we're gonna see what it sounds like with all four of the things hooked up. Here we go. Holy shit, that's loud. Excuse my language. Well, that's loud. Not what I was expecting. Thought it was gonna be one solid tone, but honestly, that sounds great. All right, back on the Boso Scoot. I haven't done anything in the last 2 days. It's Christmas, and it's been super cold. But this morning I decided to just bust out the CAD, cardboard aided design, and start on, this will be the first piece. Kind of hard to do with one hand, but let me see if I can get it. Give me 1 second, I'll see if I can balance it there. All right, there's kind of how it looks. Obviously it's gonna sit much better. And then I didn't go with the flat nose. I thought the pointed nose would be kind of cool, a little different. I also got the wing cut out. Let me grab that and I'll show you that here in a second. That looks way less impressive because it's just a flat piece of cardboard. So here's the piece of cardboard. It's a piece of this art thing my kids got for Christmas. Pretty simple, but let me just get it on there and set it up and I'll try to show you. So it's kind of just gonna slip right over there. Ooh, that piece of 2x4 was in there perfectly. Well, it'd be kind of something like that. It's gonna be out of foam, so it's gonna be about 1 inch thicker. Probably like, and then I'm hoping to kind of come up and give it a little swoop to the top, but leave the bottom flat. But it's coming along pretty cool. So after I mocked up the wing and I went inside and I had an extra like front headlight fairing that piece. So I went inside and I put the cardboard template that we had earlier for the long nose or headlight visor, whatever you want to call it. Taped all that up. So that's basically ready to be fiberglassed to make a mold. I'm going to make that removable. It's not going to get blended into the panel just because in case I want to change it, I can just kind of use double-sided tape or maybe even rib nuts. I got a new rib nut gun. That'll be pretty cool. I never used one of those. Well, I have, but only once or twice. But the next thing is exhaust. Now, I told y'all I had something pretty fun for the tip. And I started making it. I got a template right here I'm looking at. Here, I'll show you. Flip it around maybe since it's, there we go. So that'll either go, I'm not sure if I want to just go straight up and down, kind of looks boring, or if I want to go like that and have it off to the side, which I like a lot better. I do have this little tiny piece that's like a perfect curve that would, you know, sit right. Let's see if we can, okay, that'll balance there. And then this, and I'd be like, well, I don't really know. Oops, sorry. Either like that, or like that, which I don't hate. Anyways, there's some options. Well, that's gonna be the end of this episode. Unfortunately, my vacation is over, so I have to go back to work in a couple days. I got the weekend off, but then it's back to work. But that's a good thing, because when I get to work, I can order the other U-bend for the exhaust, so we can make that heart. And also, I can, sorry, I gotta show my shed here. Pick up some fiberglass, so we can start fiberglassing the wing. Well, not the wing, but the visor. And then I'll also pick up some foam, so that we can start tracing out that cardboard template for the wing and cut that up. And also we're gonna layer it so that we can kind of create a nice smooth curve, but I'll show you all that. But thanks for watching.